Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. This is the second video in three or four video series teaching you how to use your TI-36X Pro to find an area under a curve if you have a normal, standard normal distribution or just a normal distribution, or to find a z-score given the area in those two cases. So on the screen right now are the steps that I would use on the calculator for one of those two things, but I'm going to go ahead and work through that with you on the camera. So here's the problem I'm going to start with. If thermometers have an average mean reading of 0 degrees and a standard deviation of 1 degree for freezing water, and if one thermometer is randomly selected, find the probability that it reads above negative 1.23 degrees. And then find the probability that it reads between -2 and 1.5. So those are two different things. And so this is a typical thing where somebody might want to make sure that the thermometers they're going to use have a temperature range variation that's acceptable. So for the first one, we're talking about, they gave us that these were standardized. That means 0 and 1 for our mean and standard deviation. So here's our mean, which is 0. And then we have 1 standard deviation. And 2. I always suggest that you draw the picture. I'm looking at negative 1.23, so I'm going to go back here to negative 1.23. And it's saying, what's the probability that it's going to be greater than that? And you can see when you draw that, if you do spend a little time doing it correctly, you can see that this is way more than half of the time, right? Half of the time would be exactly at 0. If you're to the left of that, your probability to the right is going to be more than half the time. It's going to show that. So what we're going to do is do second function data. You can always clear your calculator to get rid of any old values. One to the right using our arrow buttons to get to distribution, and then one down to get to normal CDF, and then hit enter. Standardized is 0 and 1 for the mean and the standard deviation, sigma standing for standard deviation, so that's all set for me. I'm going to scroll through that then, and then it's going to say what's your lower bound and what's your upper bound. My lowest value that I'm interested in is negative 1.23, but my upper bound is infinite, so that's why I have 1 to the 99th power, right? That means it goes all the way forever to the right. And that gives me, rounded to the fourth place, 0.8907, which is what I would expect that my area under my curve, which is like the probability, right? It's more than 50%, quite a bit more. It's almost 90% under there. That should make sense when you look at that. And remember, whenever you're using normal CDF, that the value that you're going to get for an answer is going to be the area, which is going to be between 0 and 1 inclusive, right? There's no way to get anything more than that because this represents a probability of 100% or 1 if you think about it as an area. Okay, in the second one they say the probability that it reads between -2 and 1.5. So in this case, if we were to draw our curve, and we're going to say that here is our 0, and we want to know what is the probability that our thermometer is going to read from anywhere from -2.0, so that's exactly on that standard deviation, and then over here I have 1 and 2, and my other value is 1.5, so it's right here between the 1 and the 2. And my question that I'm answering here is, what are the chances that the thermometer that I choose will have a temperature that falls into this range? So it's a little bit harder to see than this one that it's going to be a pretty big number, but we're covering all the largest percentages, right? Because we have the top of the bell there in there. Okay, so for this one I'm going to do second function data, distribution, go down one to normal CDF, and then my mean and my sigma are what I want them to be. And I have values for both the top and the lower bound and the upper bound here. So I have -2.00. I don't really need to enter the 2.00. And I have +1.50. Again, it's going to shorten those for me. And then I'm going to hit enter. Always I can use down to get to calculate, or I can hit enter to get down there. And then I'm going to hit enter in the end. And it's going to say, okay, you've got 0.9104% of the population in there, because we have this big swath, which I was saying before, it's a little harder to see that that percentage is going to be so big. But that's how you would do a in-between problem for finding the area on a TI-36X Pro. Have a fantastic day.